even look at this crowd, although I would assume they're here for Tucker, mostly Tucker. Look at this crowd of people you have here. This is not normal. This is not normal. People you have here, but you also have a lot of people outside. When we were driving up, there are thousands of people outside here. So I was making a round a couple of days ago, and I said something that I've never said. I said, you know, I've been doing this for 9 years, and you've been with me. This is the greatest political movement in history by far. So make America great again. When our president, when our slightly off, I mean, look at the way he performed in the debate. They should have never taken it away from him. Look at the way he performed. He was really, okay. But they knew that a long time ago, okay? And she knew that too. And our country's in danger. We're dealing with Kim Jong-un. We're dealing with very, you know, we're dealing, by the way, with unbelievably smart, talented, vicious people that are at the top of their game. And we're dealing with people that, number one, aren't smart. They never were. They never were. She wasn't. She was a bad student. She couldn't pass her damn college yet. Okay? She wasn't smart. And he was definitely not smart. And we're dealing with other people that are at the absolute top of the poll. And we can't do that. That's a great danger. And people should have let us know. But I was talking, and I said, we've been doing this together for 9 years. You know, we love these people. The people are so great. They were still, it was like a sea of red, the red hat. And I said, we've been doing this together for 9 years because, you know, a year before I started, in terms of before we won, almost a year anyway. And I said, you know what? It's sad in a way because there's never been rallies like this. When that sleazebag said during the debate, she said, oh, your rallies aren't well attended and people leave. They don't leave and they're really well attended. We can't get places big enough. And then I said, you know, the rallies are the biggest in history. We never have it, just because it's a popular rally. We never had an empty seat and nobody leaves early. And you know what? If I saw people leaving, you know what I do? Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna make America great again. Goodbye, everybody. And everybody would be happy. Nobody would leave. But we don't have to do that. Nobody leaves. It's a love fest. It's never happened before. This has never happened before. He's a big fan of Ronald Reagan, so am I. But if Ronald Reagan, let's say, went to New Mexico like I did today, we'd probably have 25,000 people standing in an airport early in the morning today. But we have massive crowds. Look, we had 107,000 people in New Jersey. We had 101,000 people in Butler just a few weeks ago. We had 114,000 people in California a month ago, right? 114,000. The owner said, the person that has the land, the nice guy, he said, you get bigger crowds than these guys that play guitars on. And I don't have a guitar. So this is what the love is. I said it, and I meant it too. I said, you know, we've done this for 9 years, and it's sad. I never thought of it, actually. It'll never happen. It'll never happen again. It's not going to happen again. In 4 years, somebody's going to be running. It could be J.D. It could be he's doing a good job. It could be J.D. It could be competition no matter what. But when you have a rally, they're going to have 250 or 300 people. If Ronald Reagan came back from the dead at the height of Ronald Reagan, if he went to California to have a rally, he'd have 250, 300 people in a ballroom someplace. We have 50, 60, 70, 80, 100,000 people. And in all fairness, when they, I don't know, I have no idea, I've been doing this all day, I have no idea what time it is, but I know it's not exactly prime time for doing this stuff. And you look up into the rafters of this massive building and you don't have, there's no empty seat. it's, by the way, it's, and for whatever reason, I can't explain the reason, but it'll never happen again. And there'll be somebody running, and he'll be the hot one next year, and he'll come here, and he'll go there, and have 200-300 people, that's what it's going to be. My consultants were telling me that. Said, we've consulted for 25 years. If we'd have 300 people, we were thrilled. If we'd have 200 people, we were thrilled. And you have like 30, 40, 50, 60. In South Carolina, we had 88,000 people. In Alabama, we had 68,000 people. It's an amazing phenomenon. And I'm not giving myself, it's just, I'm giving you the credit. You're tired of being the stupid country. We become the stupid country. We're run by stupid people. It's sad, and I was telling the people, because it'll never happen again. This is never going to happen again. I don't care. I just don't believe it. It's never happened in any country. When Biden got up with the red background, the pink background, and he looked like the devil, and he looked so stupid, right? And he said, we will stop MAGA. MAGA, we're going to stop. I said, listen, you stupid bastard. MAGA means, because I think if you ask him what does it mean, he does, you know. MAGA means make America great again. That's what MAGA means. So, for the first time, I never said it to anybody, I never really thought about it that much, but all of a sudden, it was down to like maybe 10 or 8 or 9 days, a few days ago. He said, you know, in 10 days, this will never happen again. Because I'm not running again, and you're going to lose interest. We're going to meet, but we're going to meet on a different basis. We're going to meet on the basis of fixing our country, and we'll meet, but it'll be different than having rallies and having, you know, things where you have elections and all. It's never going to be what we've done together. We've got to win, first of all, but we are leading. Let's keep the cheating down. The only thing that can stop us is the cheating. It's the only thing that can stop us. If we win, it's the biggest event in political history. It's the biggest event in political history. And it's something, and it's going to be the most important. I believe that the next election is the most important election in the history of the country. I really believe that. The one that's coming up in 4 days. But I said to myself, it's sad. I told the people. Some people are in the room, they're crying. They go, we have people that have gone to 200 to 250 rallies. We have the beautiful ladies of North Carolina with the front row joys. I mean, we have people that have gone to hundreds of rallies. I said, this will never happen again. I don't believe it will. I don't think it'll ever happen again. And we'll get together, but it'll be different. We're going to get together, and we're going to make America great again. We're going to fix our country. We're going to have strong borders, and we're going to have fair elections, and hopefully we'll get a fair press election. Because that's a very important element. You need a fair press. He and I understand the press because you give them a story, you know exactly everything that happened, and they'll write it the opposite, like the exact opposite. They'll write it to actually hurt you. It's hard to believe. You almost, that's the other thing. You wonder, why do they do that? It's so bad. And they've lost such credibility. You know, when I first came to politics, the news, the press, had a 92% approval rating. Yesterday, it hit 14%. And I'm actually very proud of that, because I've exposed them for being a total fraud. They're a fraud. But hopefully they won't be a fraud for long. Hopefully that's not, because that's a very important, the press, a free press, a real press, is a very important part of greatness, of making a country great. They're almost like, they're glue that keeps it together, but they're also like, in a way, a police force that keeps it honest. But they're so dishonest that they have no credibility. Think of it. 60 Minutes asks a question. And you know, I wrote a lawsuit on this today. You saw that. 60 Minutes, because it's so long. She gives an answer that only a moron would give. You can give bad answers, but this was an answer that a person who is not a smart person, person who got the lowest score, perhaps in the history of the bar exams. Okay? You know, she found the bar exam, okay? But This is a person, this is a very low IQ individual. This is the answer of a very low IQ individual. And by the way, I think everybody that runs for president or vice president should have cognitive tests. They should have testing because, you know, and I don't mean by age, because you know some of the greatest leaders in the world were in their 80s or the 80 period, because there is an experience thing, another thing. Some of the greatest leaders in history, you look back, and I know many people that are in their 80s that are, I know one person from 80 to 90 made billions of dollars and was a failure for his whole life. And you know, I'll tell you what it's like. But he was a failure for his whole life. But I said to myself, it's sad that in a way, this whole great thing that we built is never gonna happen again. But what is gonna happen again is we're gonna turn our country around, we're gonna make it great, and we're gonna be so proud of ourselves because we have to save our country. Our country is going bad. We're a failing nation. We are, as I said, we are a nation in decline. We are a nation in very serious decline. And look at what these stupid people have done. They've allowed Russia, China, Iran, North Korea, and others to get together in a group. This is impossible to think. When I was a young guy, I always loved the whole thing, the concept of the history and all of the things that could happen. The one thing, and I had a professor at the Wharton School of Finance, but we had history classes also. He said, the one thing you never want to happen is you never want Russia and China uniting. We united them because of the oil. We united them. Biden united them. It's a shame. The stupidity of what they did. Well, I'm going to have to ununite them. I think I can do that too. You never want Russia and China. And they're natural enemies because Russia has massive land and China needs it. Okay? They need that land. China doesn't have the land for the population. Russia has, if you ever look at the size of the Russian landmass, it's like four times or five times. Doesn't have like 12 time zones or something? It's massive. They're a natural enemy. And we've allowed them to come to get together. It's such a dangerous thing. Another thing that we're doing is we're losing the dollar as the standard because of these people that are so. If we lose the dollar as the standard, that's like losing a war, and it'll never happen with me. There's no way that will happen with me. We got to put it back together. That is like losing a war. So we're going to get together, and hopefully we'll get together a lot, but we're going to get together, and I think it's going to be very happy times. We're going to put our country back together, and we're going to make it the greatest country in the world again. And you're going to be very proud of all the challenges that we have. And I just want to thank you for being here so that you have been here so long. And this is going to be fantastic.